Sorry guys, I've been away for a while, but now I'm back with a brand new tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to install the Pixabay plugin for Photoshop. And for the ones who don't know it, I'm gonna tell you what Pixabay is. Welcome back YouTube! My name is Erwin and my channel is all about photography and photo editing. If you're interested, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below and hit that small bell notification button to stay up to date when I release a new tutorial. So as you might have noticed, I've been away for a while. Now I'm back. I did some work on my backdrop, some new lights, a nice little subscriber bar, and the complete setup is done. Pixabay. You might have heard the term or the name going around. Does it destroy the stock market? Yes or no? Stock market. Now you're thinking, what? Stock market and photography? Yes, stock images. I'm talking about stock images. Just to be clear, I'm not talking about the stocks and the trading and that kind of stuff. So let's continue on Pixabay, the stock market, the image stock, the stock photos. Pixabay provides stock images. So free to use images for all kinds of stuff. You could use them in your thumbnails, in your composites. You can find them on Pixabay and you can download them there, and they're free to use in all kinds of stuff. But there are also paid stock sites like Adobe Stock, Shutterstock, or iStock from Getty Image, I think they're called today. Pixabay released a nice little plugin for Photoshop where you can search directly in their database in Photoshop. You don't need to go online and search for the image you need. You can do this directly inside Photoshop. Little side note, you need Adobe CC, so the Creative Cloud, for this to work. On CS6, I'm not sure, I did not try this. You can try it, but don't think it will be there since I'm showing it you. No, I will make use of the Adobe Creative Cloud version of Photoshop. Let's dive into the computer and I show you how to install this plugin and how to use it.
So I promised you guys, first of all, to explain what Pixabay is. To start with, Pixabay is a free, stunning images stock site. You need an account to download these images, but they are free to use. They have photos, illustrations, vectors, videos, and much more. As you can see, I'm Dutch, so I'm located in the Netherlands, so the site is displayed in Dutch. For the part we are working with, we're looking for photos. So let's hit the photos and go for exploring. It says exploring in Dutch. Now we have all the newest, lately uploaded, or most popular images they have in stock. And you can just scroll down, select an image you like, and download it. As said, you will need an account for this, so you need to set up your registration or login. For me, I already have an account and I've got it registered to my Google account, so let's drop in and we can start with this. For example, let's say I need some flowers and I want these tulips. Just hit the button, click the button, gratis or free download. You can select the quality of the image. So this is something around HD and this is the highest possible value you can get. It's the image with the best quality. For now, I will leave it here. Let's continue. This was a brief summary of what Pixabay is. Maybe I will do a tutorial in depth about Pixabay, but this is a complete other video. For now, let's dive into the add-on part. And that's what you're here about. Clap it. Now let's move over to the Adobe Exchange site, where we can find all the plugins for Photoshop CC, Lightroom CC, Lightroom Classic CC, or all other Adobe products. As you can see, the editor's choice or all extensions are directly listed on the page, which is called Creative Cloud. The homepage of Adobe Exchange looks something like this, and then we need to move over to the Creative Cloud section. Once we're here, search the marketplace for Pixabay and the free plugin will directly be shown. Just hit the icon, you go to the page and hit the free button. Sign in with your Adobe account. And the plugin will be installed. You need to activate the file sync on your Creative Cloud desktop app, as shown here. If you have so, we can continue in Photoshop. It may take a while until this plugin is installed and downloaded by your Creative Cloud desktop app. But once it's here, we can go, those are my notifications. We can go to the apps, installed apps. Let's open Photoshop. I already got it open down here. So let's open this up and take a image of Judith, for example. Once we're in Photoshop and we have this image with a gray background and we want to shove in an extra background, we will need to go into Window, Extensions, and open the Pixabay panel. It's directly here. Once you got it installed and moved into place, I've got it over here, it's just one button away. As soon as you have it, now you can search for background, for example, and you will get all the hits with the background. Now let's give Judith a nice start, a nice Milky Way background. Just take this image, click on it, and hit download. Boom, there it is. Opened in a new window. Now we can select it. Take the move tool and move it over to Judith's image. Well, the quality is less, it's smaller. It says here it's opened in 90p, but I can also download the original file size. So let's throw this away. It will be downloaded. Boom. Now we got it in original. Move it over to Judith space, and now we have something to work with. Transform it. Close this up. Overlay. Now you have a Milky Way over your photo. Now, this is only a small example of what you can do with the images from Pixabay. Not a very good example, by the way, but their library is huge. You got birds, you got animals, you got other birds, flowers, landscapes, vehicles, you name it, and you will find something on Pixabay. Don't forget, it's a free stock site, so if you're doing a commercial project and you can find something on here, it's great. But if you really need high quality images, think about it and take a look at the Adobe Stock site or at Shutterstock. The images, the database there is much bigger. They have a bigger database on images, videos, music, you name it, and they will have it. It's bigger than the database of Shutterstock or Adobe Stock is bigger than the database of Pixabay. But you have to pay for your images to use them. And also, depending on what licensing you have, you pay a bigger or smaller amount for an image.
So now you know how to use and where to find the Pixabay plugin in your Photoshop. Go out, create, teach, and be inspired by the stuff around you. If you like this video, please hit that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel by hitting the subscribe button and the bell notification button to stay up to date. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next tutorial.